Today I want to talk about how I'm heating my indoor fish pond using a heater with a built-in thermostat. My pond journey has been nothing but chaos. I've had leaks upon building new plywood ponds, and it's just been it's been crazy, but I have zero regrets because keeping these indoor fish ponds inside your house is so cool. Like, it's a new thrill that I haven't dove into in a while. I've been dealing with a lot of nano tanks, and it feels good to be dealing with monster fish again. So, let's talk about my heaters with the built-in thermostats and how I'm heating my indoor fish pond. And to do that, we are going to go to the deep depths of the basement. To give you guys a quick update on the entertainment center build, the tanks are coming together quite nicely. I do have some live plants in there. There'll be an update coming soon, though. I do have some fish in here, though, some mollies. I picked up some local mollies. Really excited about that. Picked up some plants online from a seller, a friend of mine. Shout out to She's Aquatics. So let's go into the basement. All right, so here's the pond. Please excuse the mess. I've been dealing with a lot of stuff. What I'm trying to do here is run as many sponge filters as I can in this pond because I'm going to be seeding all these sponge filters to kind of set up all the tanks here coming up soon. So here's the heaters, guys. I have them mounted above in the ceiling, the floor, rafters, whatever you want to call them. And well, actually, let's reverse a little bit, and I'll walk you through at a slower pace talking about these heaters. So these heaters are sold on Amazon, and they're kind of growing a lot of popularity. They are called the Hygor Titanium Aquarium Heater. They come in 500 watts and 800 watts. So this is either going to be used for a pond or a very large aquarium per se. And I got to say, it really catches your attention because these things are pretty cheap. It has a built-in thermostat and literally look at the price of that. And the price does fluctuate depending on where you live. I think I actually paid more than that a couple weeks ago. If I'm being honest, I was a little skeptical because if you think about it, for the price, you're getting an 800 watt titanium heater with a built-in controller on top of it. Like, that's pretty crazy. And if you think about it, a person should be running a heater controller anyways, and these happen to have a built-in one, so that's pretty nice in my opinion. When it comes to using heaters in indoor ponds, the most important thing you have to be careful of is letting the heater burn up your pond liner. That's why I wanted to think of a way that I could keep this heating element off of the bottom of the pond liner and almost have it suspend in the middle of the water column. I thought of this idea to use clamps to help suspend the heating element in the middle of the water column and hang it from the floor joist. What I did was I set a screw in the clamp, and then I could hang the wire from itself and kind of suspend the heating element. This actually worked out quite well. And yes, this is my other pool pond, the first one that had leaking problems. But guys, this general idea is what I'm going to be using from now on because it worked absolutely amazing for me. And what else could help the heating element is also using some water flow in there, like some wave makers or however you can make your water move a little bit. So as you can see, Ruby's no help as of usual. Huh? Huh? What are you doing on your phone here? Huh? Sitting on Facebook? You trolling in a Facebook group? Huh? If you don't follow the channel, to update you guys, that pool pond actually did leak twice. So I had to build this pond. And yes, I am using the same heater setup. I'm using two of them together. It's working quite well. Literally, what I did was the same design. I just screwed a clamp into the floor joist, and I'm hanging the controller here, and it just kind of hangs on itself. I zip-tied the slack to kind of have it so the height was perfect so that the heater unit suspends by itself. You can see the big dovi down there itself. And it's working quite well, guys. The only issue I had was having two of these on the same breaker, essentially. They're both 800 watts. I had to have them on different outlets because together they were popping breakers. So, but that has nothing to do with the pond. These guys worked very well. I'll throw a link in the description, guys. What you do is, without touching anything, it tells you the water temp. But if you click it, it tells you what you have your heater set at. So it's very simple. I have this pond is set at 76. I just set them both to 76 and they work very well together. So, and you can change those between Fahrenheit and Celsius. I'm obsessed with these heaters. I literally paid $90 for each of these. So I'm $180 plus tax, so around $200 USD. And it is holding this pond to temperature quite well. And what I'm also working on doing is insulating the pond, and I'm building lids right now because if you're looking to kind of help heat your pond better, lids kind of help hold the temperature in. And insulating around here. I'm gonna insulate it, I'm gonna wrap it, and then I'm gonna use the greenhouse siding for the tops, the polycarbonate. And that's what I'm doing right here. I'm cutting it. And it what's cool about building your pond the same size as a sheet of plywood is that everything is easy to do. You could literally cut the plywood in half to build the walls. The sheet of polycarbonate actually comes in a 4x8 sheet. So it's literally very little cutting. I would advise you guys to do the same. What I'll have to do with the tops is just kind of nibble out a little spot for the cord here for the heaters, and that's about it. I'll have to cut a spot for the airline. But guys, these heaters work tremendously good for my indoor fish pond. They have thermostats built in. I highly advise the Hygor heater. I'll throw a link in the description box. The fish are doing great. Look at that Dovi right there. God dang, isn't he just amazing? Let me see if I can zoom. Look at him, guys. You can see his front teeth. I'm thinking I'm going to have problems with him though, because like a lot of people have said, he's a Dovi. And even though I have him with very large cichlids, you can see him over there. Those are 12-inch Midas cichlids. He still is chasing them. He's bullying them. He's finally figuring out that he is a Dovi. So I don't know, guys. Should I keep him? Should I get rid of him? He's kind of a psychopath, but I knew what I was getting into. I've done tons of videos on Dovi, and I know what I'm getting myself into. He's probably at least 13 inches long. But yeah, guys, let me know in the comment section. I have a buyer that wants to buy him, so it's just like, I just don't know what to do, you know what I mean? Good money too, if I'm being honest, but it's just like, I finally got my hands on a Dovi. Should I keep him? I haven't had a Dovi in so long. All right, guys, let me know in the comment section what you think of my indoor fish pond heaters with thermostats. So if you've used these, please give me a comment. Let me know what you think, if you might think about buying these. You can also use them in larger aquariums. They come with clamps that you can put on the side of the glass, so it's pretty cool. But as you guys know, with heaters, they're going to be the most beneficial in the middle of the water column with current. So, all right, guys, I'm going to end this. Woo-woo.